Welcome to meditation. This week, the meditation is actually coming from England. I'm away for a few weeks on vacation, so I apologize for the lateness. But let us begin. Find a chair where you feel comfortable but supported. And if you wish to close your eyes, please do so. We're going to start with breathing in and breathing out. So let's breathe in. And breathe out. As you breathe in, scan your body, relaxing your muscles, starting with the head, by unfurling your brow, letting your chin drop, relax your shoulders so that they just droop. As you're breathing in and out, relax the muscles in your back and your legs. So that the chair is supporting you. Feel your body sink into that chair. Making your hands soft and gentle. And as you breathe in and breathe out, remember this is your time. Mind gets distracted. Acknowledge those thoughts and put them aside. You can come back to them. If you hear sounds that might distract you, acknowledge those sounds and put them aside. In this sacred space, as we breathe in, we're breathing in the breath of God, filling our lungs and blowing out. Let's do that again. Breathe in the breath of God, fill your lungs. Blow away any tension that you may be holding in your body. And as the world fades away, you're making this space for you. Thank you. invite you to breathe in, inviting the Holy Spirit to descend upon you. You may imagine it as a warm shower that comes upon your head and cascades over your shoulders, warming your body. As you breathe in again, you may wish to invite God to come and sit beside you. You may wish to sit in silence or open your heart to God. Listen to the Spirit that moves your spirit. So breathe in and breathe out. I'd like to take you on a journey way back to the early church. The Apostle Paul was a great evangelical preacher on the behalf of spreading the good news to Jews and Gentiles in the countries that he visited. But he couldn't do this alone. He needed support. So today, I'd like you to think of Prisca, or as we know her as Priscilla. Priscilla was the wife of Aquila. Priscilla and Aquila are known for being one in marital bliss because they shared all things. They were one in the Lord, and both of them became followers of Christ. They were one family business, for they were tent makers. And they were one in their friendship with Paul, because he stayed with them, not for a few days, but for 2 years. They were one in their knowledge of Scripture, and they taught others. Priscilla being known as a deacon, a leader within the congregation. Yes, their home was in service to the early church. Their home was open. you're all together. Story. Who are you? Gently open your eyes. we are asked who we are, we usually respond with a title or how we're employed. But I invite you to consider yourself in all the things you do, whatever they may be. And who you are is an ambassador for Christ. Finish our meditation today. I invite you to say the following with me. I am an ambassador for Christ, disguised as a. I am called to convey the love and truth of Jesus to the people in my sphere of influence. Amen. So until our next meditation, which I hope will be on time, I will still be away, but I will be very pleased for you to join me again. Until then, may God be with you, keep you safe, and that you remember that as you are loved by God, you are an ambassador of Christ.